Here with Coach Karen Ferguson, days after a 3-0 win over Pittsburgh on homecoming. Coaches, take us through the process of the win tonight.
Wasn't really a very attractive soccer game, to be honest with you. Not a lot of possession, but two goals off of set pieces and the one off of a repress, which is who we are. So I think that's what I have to continue to focus on. It wasn't attractive. There wasn't a lot of possession for either team. To be honest, they might have had a little bit more possession than we had, but very unorthodox style. So for us, it was unorthodox for us to have to play against. But I love that we got two goals early, and then we're able to kind of set the tempo, dictate the rhythm of the rest of the game.
On homecoming, that means one thing. It's close to the end for the seniors. I'm sure you get some great memories with these girls. Just share some of the feelings you had going into this with them.
Yeah, this is a great group, man. This is an unbelievable group of seniors, academically, athletically, quality of character, soccer players. So it's nice. We want to continue to elongate the season for them. And this was nice to be able to get a 3-0 win for them. They've meant a ton to the program. Five of the six of them have been here for 4 or 5 years, and then Daryl was only here 2 years. Unfortunate for Daryl and Shelby to have the injuries and not be able to play this year, but still have been tremendous part of our program. And then the other four, it was awesome to get Tori in tonight, which is good. She's been a backup goalkeeper. That's difficult. The role she plays is super difficult, so we appreciate her, and it was nice to be able to get her in. And she came out and boxed one ball. She punched one ball right out of the 18, so good for her.
KB just always seems so enthusiastic, always so positive, always so happy. She's had to be a joy for you to coach.
From the first phone call I took with her, I knew we wanted that kid at the University of Louisville. Just reeked of positivity and optimism and hope and belief. And gosh, how easy is that to coach, right? So she's been a joy. She's been the leader of our back line for 4 years. She's been a captain and a very good captain. So she'll definitely be missed. And so will Allison Price, who's been our warrior. She's the toughest kid I think I've ever coached. Kayla Dickerman didn't have the greatest night tonight, but certainly Kayla's played significant minutes for us. And then Tori gets in a little bit towards the end, so that was nice for the four that are healthy enough to play.
Following today's win, it kind of puts you into eighth place right at the cutoff line for the ACC tournament. How confident are you, because the quality of the team has picked up a lot lately.
Yeah.
So how confident are you the team can take care of business for the remainder of the season and then qualify for the tournament to kind of, like you said, elongate the season?
That's the goal for sure, but we don't focus on that. I think we're playing our best soccer right now, so we'll just continue to be Louisville women's soccer. Mm-hmm. Wake Forest is good. They're good. But I think we're pretty good. So, we'll get back after it tomorrow. We'll train, regen a little bit, Sunday off, and prepare Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday. So, of course, I'm confident because I love the group that we get to coach, and we want to elongate the season as long as we can.
Nemo with a little bit of ice on the shoulder there at the end of that. She went down pretty rough there. Is she okay as far as y'all can tell?
She's okay. She is. She's shoulders in. I think that's a dangerous tackle. In all honesty, I think it's more than a yellow, but that's okay. That's his call. Shoulder and her knee, but just bruised. She'll be okay. She'll be sore tomorrow, but she'll be okay after that.
All right, Coach, congratulations on the shutout win, and a happy homecoming to you.
Thanks.